First of all, I will request everyone, please stay in your home. Think about all those children ones. Those children have absolutely no idea about this epidemic. Please stay at home. Give these little ones a chance to survive. So most of all, we use a switch to turn on every home appliances. So how would it be like to turning on just by using a remote? At the same time, if it is too easy to make, your wish will be fulfilled through this video. Today in this video, we will see how a functional remote control system can be made with a very easy process, through which you can turn off 4 things in your room's appliances. And guys, English is not my language, sorry for this accent, so please consider me. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. This company producing prototype PCB in very insane quality. Not only that, you can find variety type of option when you are ordering your PCB. Such as you can order maximum 6 layer PCB, even you can get here the benefit of SMT service and stain seal. Even you can order huge amount of PCB in your budget. And more useful offer is you can select variety type of color of PCB with absolutely free of cost. More information, you can visit their website. Okay, at first, look this circuit, which I made on this breadboard. You can see here is no any complicated component. And this circuit look like very easy, am I right? And maybe you have noticed here is only a 8-pin IC and a IR sensor. That's it. And your circuit is done. And according to this diagram, I made this circuit. And this circuit diagram always you can find in the description box. For IR input signal, I am using here this common remote. You can use any kind of remote as you want. Example, you can use your TV remote, even you can use your set-top box remote. But here I am choose this remote because this is a very smaller size and suitable for use. Okay, let's go deeper. Every remote has a IR sensor that produces infrared ray. You can't see infrared ray in naked eye. And if you using your smartphone's camera, then you can capable to see in this infrared ray. If you notice this infrared ray with carefully, then you can see this ray are blinking. If I think this power button is producing 41 and 40, then next button will be different. In the same way, here is separate code provided from all those buttons. And I need to know the exact code of each button on this remote to handle it properly. So that's why I will take help from Arduino to analyze code. So I download a library file called IR library. And this code I put into my Arduino. Next, I will mount a IR sensor on this breadboard. And obviously, I not forget to connect 5V with this sensor. Next, I connect IR sensor output pin with Arduino's digital pin 9. Next, this time I will open the serial monitor inside my Arduino IDE software. Now the funny thing is, when I push one of the button on this remote, the binary code of that button immediately showing me here. I need 4 buttons here, those are 1, 2, 3, 4. And obviously I will remember all those buttons binary code to build my software. With all this thing in my mind, I will create a software that allow to me control 4 things remotely. It is pretty easy. I am using the IR library here, so I will mention it here. Then I will mention here the IR sensor pin and also mention 4 output pin for appliances. Next, I need to write some in void loop. Do you remember the 4 buttons binary code that you have in mind? You need to put that code here. And you must mention here how the output will be respond after receiving this IR sense. That's your little 4 to 5 line of code. That's it. At first I thought I would make it by Arduino, but then I thought, why would I use such a large IC for such a small thing? So here I used my most favorite 1885 IC. It is a good IC, it has a 6 IO pin and 8KB internal memory. It is the only one suitable IC for my work. So do not waste time in any way. Then I made a circuit with this IC on this copper dot board. And look, it worked pretty well as I expected. But it is not capable for running any AC appliances because in India 220V AC is used. And this board is running only 3.7V battery. That's why you have to use the triac or relay to drive AC voltage. At first I thought I would use triac here, but it used to be quite complicated. So with all that in my mind, I would use relay here. Result, you can make it at home in very simple way. Since this relay are running through 12V, so I used 4 transistor to drive 4 12V relays. I used SMD transistor here, you can use any kind of transistor. And the thing to keep in mind, if you want to make it on copper dot board, so please remove the copper trace between AC and DC to avoid short circuit. In additional, I used 5V regulator IC, which is used to handle microcontroller. Okay, let's test it out in AC volt. I will connect AC 220V wire to this terminal. Next, I will add 12V power source wire to this terminal for off-rate relay and microcontroller. And for the purpose of checking, I attached 4 filament bulb to this 4 terminal. And you can see this will work in extraordinary way that I expected. Note guys, if you have no experience with electronics, I would suggest you not make it because electric is not funny thing. One small mistake you can put you in a lot of danger. Guys, one thing more, this is a 1500 watt inverter by which I turn on these 4 bulbs. See this, it looks so easy, doesn't it? So maybe in the next video I will try to show you how to make it. So I hope you have learned something special through this video. If you want more video like this, then please subscribe my channel.